Exactly, Homa. Oh my gosh.
So let's catch you up where we were at last.
Yeah, if you didn't see the last vlog,
we got a load out of California.
And we're heading to Missouri.
Yep, near St. Louis.
Yep, and we have made it into Oklahoma now. We are, what, 554 miles from the drop?
Yeah, not far. No. We have had a busy, busy morning.
Yeah, well, you have. I've been sleeping.
I have, yeah.
I got up about 2 hours ago, 3 hours ago, maybe. Yeah.
We got a bunch of loads lined up, and we are booked out till next Wednesday.
Yeah, everything goes right. So yeah, we deliver this one tomorrow in Missouri, and then we have one picking up tomorrow. It's a short one. Deliver it Monday. Then we got another one, but we won't talk about any of that yet, because you know how we feel about that. Yep. We don't want to be jinxed.
We'll talk about one of the ones.
Yeah, in this vlog, because we'll be picking it up tomorrow, as long as everything goes smooth and it doesn't cancel. And
Oh man, it was cold last night. Got down to 11 degrees.
And I got into a few little snow flurries just west of Flagstaff when you're coming down or going up that mountain pass there.
Yeah, yeah.
Of course, I couldn't get it in on the GoPro or anything because it was dark
out.
You wouldn't have been able to see it. But I did stop at that rest area up there that they have open now for trucks. And I did my 30-minute and let the babies out, and it was snowing.
Just a little bit, yeah.
That first snow.
I didn't get any snow. It was just cold going through New Mexico.
But on the way, you had said it was snowing in Amarillo before you got there.
Before I got there, yeah. Mm-hmm. By the time I got there, they had already cleaned it all up and sanded and did their thing and made it right through it, like half hour past Amarillo, and it was all cleared up again.
Yeah.
And the roads are good in Oklahoma.
Yeah, it's
just
cold. Cold and dreary. 36
degrees here. It warmed up into the 30s when I got into Texas, but all New Mexico was
11 degrees.
11, 18, like it fluctuated in the teens. So.
Oh my
God. Missy.
I hate the cold.
I already let you out. Mama's going to let you out in a little bit.
Yeah, I'm going to take over so this one can get some sleep. He's tired. He had a long night.
Long night. First run, always back. It's always a whip. But
yeah, well, we did that short run in California. But
yeah, but that was just like a little day tripper.
Yeah, that was an easy, quick run to do. Yeah, but yeah, when you always have had some time off sitting, it's, it takes a bit to get back into it, but
I figure it out. I drink a bunch of caffeine,
a bunch of coffee,
get through the night, sleep really good the next day,
he'll be out today.
Don't matter what bad roads, how hard she slams on the brake, who cuts her off.
Speaking of bad roads, the new shocks are doing really well.
Oh,
smoother ride.
There was nothing wrong with the old shocks.
No.
They were just old.
Yeah, they start getting worn out.
They wear out. They don't respond to bumps as well.
Yeah.
So we've just, ever since being an owner-operator, we just change them every 100,000 miles.
Yeah, and we're actually at almost 115,000 miles now. So
yeah,
it was time. And we had the time to do it, so...
Yeah, I think we had it knocked out in like half an hour.
Oh, yeah, it was easy.
40 minutes, maybe.
You have that impact wrench, so that makes it a lot easier.
I love that thing.
It actually almost seemed a little bit easier changing them on this than it did the M2.
I think just because we knew what we were doing.
That's probably it.
Yeah, we kind of got the idea of what we're doing now. So.
Definitely something you
can when you do something a few times, you get used to it and you know what you're doing.
Yeah. I mean, gosh, we always love doing stuff ourselves if we can, save a little money, you know, because I don't know, I remember how much the shocks cost us.
$100
each. $100 each, and then no labor because we did it ourselves. Yeah. And if you have somebody else do it, they're going to charge you with their hourly rate.
I think our impact gun's already paid for itself.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, yeah. We did
out of
that.
All the shocks we've done already, it's already paid for
itself.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah.
That is true. So, But oh my gosh, yeah, I'm still kind of sleepy. I'm gonna make me another cup of coffee. And
you're gonna hang out here for a little bit, aren't
you? Yeah, yeah. In the life, you've seen the last vlog. We thought that they had parking at the drop off, and come to find out, they're not letting trucks park there anymore.
Yeah.
So we can't go straight there. So yeah, we'll have to kill a little bit of time.
Yeah.
I'm gonna kill a little bit of time here. Then I'm gonna fuel at TA Mount Vernon and kill some time there. And then that'll put us about 250 miles away. So kill a bit of time there and then get going again. And by the time you get up, you won't have too far and you'll have to kill a little bit of time before we deliver in the morning.
Yeah.
But I think we can get there at like 6:30 in the morning.
What tarnation is this redneck tweaker doing?
Somebody pulling a trailer. I don't know. He's got a motorcycle, a chair, and an ottoman.
And an ottoman. He just parked right in the middle of the parking lot. And
yeah, we're parked at a casino here.
He got a light bar on his hood.
Oh, he does.
Yeah.
He's gonna blind you.
Yeah.
We tried to stop at, there's a Love's right here. Jason was going to get some lotto tickets because it's up there. And he likes to get lotto tickets every now and then. But it's packed over there. So
it was like 3 trucks deep in every fuel island. So yeah, we'll wait.
The casino here allows truck parking, so we've parked right here next before.
We've done driver swaps here a bunch of times.
Yeah,
always a spot open.
Oh yeah, easy in, easy out.
Yeah,
right off of the 40. But yeah, I guess we're rambling now.
We're just rambling. I'm gonna go lay down because I'm done.
Yeah. We'll want to catch up with you guys tomorrow after we get delivered
and our next one picked up and tell you all about her. She always poops.
She pooped twice.
That girl always pooping. She's
they always pooping. Happy Friday, y'all.
Happy Friday. We are dropped and loaded.
That's right. It was that man. That went smooth.
That was smooth.
That was like one of the quickest
deliveries.
Well,
the pickup took a little.
Well, not bad.
Pickup was
though.
Like an hour.
Not bad. But that's only because they were expecting us later in the
day.
They were. But, I mean, we were there maybe 30, 45 minutes.
They weren't expecting us until noon.
Yeah.
So, and we showed up at like
7.
7 o'clock. Yeah. So, we got offloaded at 6.
Yeah.
We had 20-mile deadhead.
20-mile deadhead.
I think that's our least mile deadhead ever.
So, yeah, 20 miles to pick up.
Yeah, nothing.
Nothing. So, so we picked up in Missouri, and we are heading to Texas.
Woohoo!
It's not a long load, about 800 miles.
Yeah.
We got one piece at 155 pounds. Can't deliver it till Monday. So,
but like we said yesterday, we do have something lined up out of Texas.
We do for Tuesday because we deliver this Monday. The next one's Tuesday. You'll find out about that in the next vlog.
Yeah.
But
I've already called a RV place.
RV park,
8 miles away from our delivery. So we're going to get down there tomorrow.
We'll probably get down there late tonight. Because we're going to pretty much drive straight down.
Yeah.
We're going to take our time, but we're going to drive straight down.
We're going to get to the Houston area tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Find somewhere to park for the night, wake up tomorrow morning, go to the RV park.
And have a nice little weekend at the RV park before we
Going to be doing Monday. Laundry. And
we do need to do laundry. Yeah, look, they have laundry there, so hopefully the spot gets close by.
Good times.
Yeah, good times. But, man, it's just been cold.
Has it been that? Not like New Mexico cold.
Yeah, that's true.
That was cold.
At least we ain't got in any snow. Except
no
for the
snow.
Little flurries I got into before Flagstaff.
Yeah.
No, it's...
Yeah. We've been having a problem with our Qualcomm today.
Yeah.
I don't know what the deal is. I wonder if everybody else, because I know I called and I found out it was an Omnitrax thing. Something's wrong with their system. So anybody out there uses Omnitrax, today is 12/4 Friday. You'll have to tell us when you watch this video if you
yeah, if you're having problems.
Problems last week for you.
Yeah, but
it's
yeah.
today for us.
Yeah. Yeah, always a week behind. Our videos are always a week behind. I know always. Most of you all know that and realize that, but yeah. we'll get people that email us, like they'll see a vlog. And
oh, you're in Washington.
Say, oh yeah, let me know when you get here. I'd love to meet you, but that was a week ago.
Yeah.
And you know, we do that for a lot of reasons.
It takes time to edit and
time, yes.
Yeah, and we're out here working, so
right.
like even making time to do videos is pretty struggling sometimes.
Yeah, it is. Luckily, I've been able to keep up with it pretty good since we pretty much had a whole week off during Thanksgiving and not doing much.
I've been kind of trying to push her to do a little bit of video editing each day. Hey, you got some clips. Let's do that.
Yeah, it makes it easier when I can do a little bit each day. Like, whatever we did that day, edit that up so I'm not having to do a whole vlog in one sitting.
But after driving 12 hours, you don't want to touch nothing. You want
to... I don't want to do it after I've, been on a 12-hour shift. And then, even though, like, I don't usually lay down right away. I'll stay up maybe an hour and talk with Jason or whatever.
Yep.
And I don't want... It's hard to edit in a moving truck, first of all.
It is.
When you're trying
is.
To
you're
do
trying
the
to
jump cuts.
Do cuts and clips and add transitions.
Yeah.
And Yeah, no. Not easy at all.
Mm-mm. But are we still in Missouri?
Yeah, we'll be in Missouri for a little bit.
Okay.
We're heading down through Memphis, gonna get on the 30, go down towards Texarkana, and then down towards Houston off, I think it's 59?
Yeah, we're delivering out
bunch
near
of back
Houston.
Roads in Texas.
Yeah, but they're not bad back roads.
75 miles an hour in Texas.
Yeah.
Texas don't play.
Just gotta watch for them deers.
Yeah.
That's the one thing I hate about driving back roads at like dusk and nighttime and dawn
Especially
even.
Especially East Texas.
The deers, yeah.
There's a lot of deer in East Texas.
Mm. Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna lay down early so I can get up
Yeah, I'm gonna
later.
Go ahead and take over. And
yeah, she's taking over. I'm laying down early.
Knock out a bunch of miles.
It's 800. She'll probably do about 400. Stop until once I get my 10 hour, then I'll take over and get us the rest of the way. Probably be around midnight.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just going to go
midnight.
Until you wake up, and even if I knock out 600 miles.
10:30 now, so yeah, 11 o'clock midnight, we'll be in Texas or down in the Houston area, so.
Yeah.
Cool.
Well, cool. We'll go get some rest and I'll knock out some miles and we'll talk to you guys later.
Tomorrow
for us. In the next clip for you.
Yeah.
From Houston, Texas.
Yep. Houston, Texas. We made it down here to the campground.
RV park.
Yeah.
We are doing laundry.
Yep.
Taking advantage of their laundry facilities. This is a really nice RV park.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. Cheap too. It's like $41.
Yeah, I'll have to link them down in the descriptions. They're straight truck friendly. I know. I just put everything in the washers and it's hot in here.
It is super hot.
But yeah, I'll link their website down in the description if y'all are in the Houston area and need somewhere to stay.
South Houston, down off the...
Off 45 the, and the Beltway 8.
Yeah, so it'd be South Houston. Nice little park, friendly people.
Yeah, so nice. But we are gonna... I just placed an Instacart order, which I have been loving Instacart because they'll just shop for your stuff and bring it to you. I'll have to talk about it more in a video because I've been using it for a couple months now and I love it. And yeah. I just placed an order for some groceries.
All right.
All right, I'm gonna get those laundry going and we'll check up with you guys later. Sunday fun day.
There it is.
Man, we are enjoying this nice little RV park.
Yeah, we've been chilling out, got laundry done today, got some video editing done this morning.
Actually got laundry done yesterday.
Yeah.
And so we decided we were gonna go out to eat last night. And yeah. Jason was looking up places and he yeah. found this Mexican food place called Ojos Locos Tacos or something like that.
Yeah.
And it looked really good. And on their description, it said like waitresses in short skirts were like, oh, it's like a Hooters.
Kind of like a Hooters.
Tacos and wings. We got there and those girls were in straight up lingerie.
Lingerie, bras.
I was like, dang.
Fishnet stockings, like lace. I was like, oh my
Thongs.
God. She was looking more than I was.
I was like, what in the world?
We got a picture of her with our waitress.
Yeah, we'll put it up here. But yeah. If you follow Jason on Instagram at Blue Collar Nomad, he had put some pictures up. You'll have to go check out. But my gosh, I was like, what? They made Hooters girls look like saints.
Saints, yeah. Yeah, it was pretty funny. We weren't expecting it. The food was pretty good.
It was decent, yeah.
Yeah, their tacos were amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, crazy. And then somebody said they have one in Dallas, too. I've never heard of the place.
I'd never heard of them either. I just seen Ojos Locos. I'm like, oh, this is probably a Mexican place. And we want a Mexican, so we're like, let's go check it out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we weren't expecting that, but
yeah.
Jason, we've got like this marinated chicken breast that Jason's going to do on the Traeger.
Yeah.
And we need pellets.
We need pellets because I'm all out. So yeah. I'm going to have to run to a Home Depot, get an Uber ride or Lyft or something. And
we stopped after we ate. We took an Uber to the Home Depot that's right here by the RV park. And they didn't have any pellets last night.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to get that today so yeah. we can cook that. And I'm going to make the little stuffed sweet peppers to go with it. But not much else going on today. Just enjoying this lovely day.
Yeah,
it's a little chilly.
Chilly, but the sun's out today, so we're enjoying that.
We deliver our load tomorrow morning. Then we have to deadhead a little bit for our next one, which you'll find all about out in the next
vlog.
About
180 miles,
yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah, not bad. I'm just glad we got another load lined up.
Yeah, we got another one. Hopefully we can make next week a banger week.
Yeah, we only got a couple weeks till Christmas, so
yeah.
We need to make these weeks count with loads.
Yeah, yeah.
But we're going to go ahead and end this one here, guys. Stay tuned for the next vlog. See where we're heading next.
Sounds good.
Thank you guys, as always, for watching and subscribing.
And until our next video.
Peace, love, and expediting.